I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you, everyone. Okay, we will have the approval of the minutes of the June 18th, 2020 Commissioners' Meeting, the June 18th, 2020 Phase 3 and Beyond Meeting, and the June 23rd, 2020 Operations Meeting. If there are no objections or corrections, the minutes will stand approved as presented. Hearing no objections, the minutes will be approved. Are there any public comments on the printed agenda items? Comments can be typed into the Q&A portion of Microsoft Teams. Are there any comments listed?
There is one comment, but I'll read it at the end of the meeting. And I'm going to make the public comment announcement. Public comment will be accepted through the Q&A function. Please include your first name, last name, and municipality. Any comments without name and municipality will not be considered. Each citizen can submit one comment that is no more than 3 minutes per comment. The meeting comment period is limited to 30 minutes in total. Please be concise. Comments will be read during the meeting and should not be considered to be interactive dialogue with the commissioners. Any commissioner response to the public comment will be done at the discretion of the commissioners. Thank you.
Thank you very much. So I'm a little out of kilter here this morning. We'll get this figured out. That's my fault. So we don't have public comment on agenda items. If there are any, before we make a motion to approve, I will ask again if there are any, because I don't want to rush this, but I want to make sure everybody has an opportunity if they have any questions on the agenda items.
Sorry, Commissioner, the comment is quite long. It literally just came over. It is in regards to a Reading library. So I don't believe it pertains to anything on the agenda. I'll read that comment at the end of the meeting.
All right, that's a general comment to the commissioners. Thank you very much. Okay, enactment of an ordinance, ordinance 2-2020, amending ordinance 0106 that authorized the Board of Commissioners of the County of Berks to enter into an intergovernmental agreement to establish the Berks County Uniform Construction Code Board of Appeals in cooperation with participating municipalities within the county. Under item 2, authorizing budget department, adopt the resolution authorizing budget transfers in the amount of $230,596 and 2020 appropriations in the amount of $282,345 for listing date of June 22nd, 2020. Under human resources, we have two items. Adopt the resolution authorizing a temporary promotion of Kurt Katzenmoyer from assistant chief deputy coroner to acting chief deputy coroner in the coroner's department. Replacement for John Hollenbach, who will serve as acting coroner due to the retirement of Dennis J. Hess. Item 2, authorized promotion of Debbie Detweiler from part-time deputy investigator to full-time assistant chief deputy coroner in the coroner's office. Replacement for Kirk Katzenmoyer, who was temporarily promoted as acting chief deputy coroner. Under purchasing, adopt the resolution authorizing the award and director of contracts and procurements to execute a contract for a 2-year term as a result of request for proposals 20-14-CN for Employment Advancement and Retention Network EARN services follows. Educational Data Systems out of Dearborn, Michigan, total not to exceed $998,226. Under item B, adopt the resolution authorizing the award and director of contracts and procurement to execute as a result of invitation to bid 4 contracts for the Agricultural Center exterior renovation project as identified herein. The general construction goes to York Construction of Reading, PA. Amount for general construction, $139,000. Under plumbing for Shannon A. Smith of Myerstown, $25,202. And electrical, Shannon A. Smith of Myerstown. Amount for electrical construction not to exceed $209,250. Under the commissioners, item A, adopt the resolution authorizing Kevin Barnard, vice chair, to execute amendment number 4 to license agreement with the University of Pittsburgh of the Commonwealth System of Higher Education for use by the University of the Berks County Children and Youth Services training room on the 9th floor, the Berks County Services Center, for a one-year term beginning July 1 through June 30, 2021. Under item B, adopt the resolution authorizing Kevin S. Barnhart as vice chair to execute the amendment to county application for GEMS program funds for the Department of State for reimbursement of new voting equipment in the amount of $65,670. Under item C, adopt the resolution ratifying, confirming, and approving Christian Leinbach as chair to execution of Motorola Solutions change order number one, MOT80989, dated June 17, 2020, to add 10 full VESTA positions to side B for the VESTA 911 system, including all hardware, software implementation, project management, software support, and on-site maintenance, and a heads-up display replacing IP phones in the amount of $498,311.04. Item D, adopt the resolution authorizing directing Christian Y. Leinbach as chair and Ron Seaman as chief administrative officer to take any and all actions necessary in the application for an administration of the CARES funding grant in the amount of $38,034,840 under contract number C00007-3969, being administered by the PA Department of Community and Economic Development, and further resolving that the electronic signing of both the application and grant agreement and contract by the four said officials be hereby ratified, confirmed, and approved. And we found out late yesterday afternoon we were in fact approved. So going along with the resolution will be the contract that will need to be signed, and then we'll be receiving the $38 million through DCED for the administration of CARES funding. So that is moving forward. And I really want to again recognize Ron Seaman for his diligence in making the application for this money for the CARES Act allotment through DCED. A lot of work, and thank you, Ron, for that and others. Item E, adopt the resolution authorizing Kevin Barnhart as vice chair to execute the memorandum of understanding between Berks County Workforce Development Board, PA CareerLink, Berks County One-Stop Partners, and the County of Berks regarding the operation and management of the PA CareerLink Berks County program, providing local oversight of workforce programming in Berks County for the period July 1, 2020 through June 30, 2023. Item F, adopt the resolution authorizing Kevin Barnhart as vice chair to execute the memorandum of understanding, operating budget and infrastructure funding agreement between the Berks County Workforce Development Board, PA CareerLink, Berks County One-Stop Partners, and the County of Berks regarding the operation and management of the PA CareerLink Berks County program providing local oversight of workforce programming in Berks County for the period July 1, 2020 through June 30th, 2021. I didn't repeat myself. There are two separate actual resolutions. Item G, adopt the resolution authorizing execution of the Berks County Coronavirus Emergency Supplemental Grant Agreement through the Berks Pennsylvania Commission on Crime and Delinquency in the amount of $213,286 to support Berks County's law enforcement efforts to respond to COVID-19. That PCCD grant, there apparently is going to be another like one in the fall for $213,286 allocated to Berks County. And this initial grant is going to be used for PPE as well as for protective barriers in the court system for the sheriff and the jail. Item H, adopt the resolution of the Berks County Board of Commissioners declaring the continuation of the declaration of the disaster emergency for the County of Berks issued March 12th of 2020 due to COVID-19, and further declaring all provisions of the March 12th, 2020 Declaration of Disaster Emergency continue to remain in full force and effect until December 31, 2020, unless amended by vote of a majority of the board. This goes to coincide with the approval of the CARES Act funding and the contract, so that as we are expending CARES Act money between now and the end of the year, our declaration of emergency also parallels that as we submit invoices to DCED. Item three, motion authorizing execution of contract agreements and amendments as furnished by the contract coordinator is set forth on the attached listing dated June 23rd, 2020. We have 25 contracts, one with the Area Agency on Aging, 14 with Children and Youth Services, 2 with Facilities, 1 with Juvenile Probation, and 7 with Mental Health and Developmental Disabilities. And finally, item 4, motion to ratify and confirm payments set forth in Controller's Office vouchers for week ending June 24, 2020, and the payment of electronic transfers and employee payroll. There you have our agenda for today. And again, I will just ask if there are any questions there, Jesse, that pertain to the agenda items.
Okay. Sorry. don't believe specifically to any agenda items. I've been reading down all of the comments.
Just want to make sure we don't miss anything that's relative to the agenda.
Yeah, I'm just trying to keep up with these.
They all look like general comments.
Yeah, there's a mixed bag of comments. I don't see anything specific. If anyone else reading them on our team sees that, just point that out to me, but I do not see anything specific to any agenda items.
Okay. Yeah, I didn't either.
Very good. So then I'll ask for a motion to approve.
I move to approve the agenda as presented.
And I will second. Any questions on the motion to approve the agenda? All those in favor, consent by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Ayes have it. Report of the treasurer. Dennis, are you with us this morning?
I am with you.
Good man. Thank you.
Is everybody happy and healthy? That's the real important question.
Yes, far so good. Thank you.
We have an opening balance today of $217,478,080.20. A balance to clear of $3,289,354.23. And that leaves us a balance of $214,188,725.97.
Very good. Thank you. And our controller, Sandy Graffius. There you are. The controller's report.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Our total accounts payable this week was $3,986,536. We had a payroll, $4,239,988.02, for a grand total of $8,226,524.98.
Very good. Thank you, Sandy. And the report of our Chief Administrative Officer, Ron Seaman.
I don't have anything at this time. Thank you.
Thank you, Ron. I will move to Commissioner Rivera and any comments you might have.
Yes, thank you, Commissioner Barnhart. I know Commissioner Barnhart earlier has spoken about the CARES Act money, and he had thanked Ron Siemens for his work. I also want to thank Ron for the work he did in that, everyone else who helped on the team, and also Commissioner Barnhart, because he did not mention it, but he was directly involved with Ron Siemens in that aspect, and both of them put in a lot of time and hours to make that happen. So Commissioner Barnhart, thank you for your work in making sure that we got that in on time, that we got it approved, and we're all gonna continue to work together to make sure that that money gets used in the best way possible for the benefit of all Berks County. So thank you.
Thank you so much. Appreciate it.
You're welcome. Next, I'd like to remind everyone that tomorrow Berks County is going green, and there's a few things that change and a few things that have not. As they're in reference to changes, businesses that were not able to open but now open, there are certain limitations, certain restrictions. Some need to be by appointments only. Restaurants can open inside but only to 50% capacity. So there's a lot of good things that are going on. So this weekend, if you have the time and are able to, please get out, support those businesses that were closed during this time period. They do need your support. One thing that has not changed is that we all must continue to do our part to stop the spread. We need to continue wearing our masks. We need to continue with social distancing. We need to continue washing our hands frequently. We need to continue doing all those things we have been doing so far. We need to continue doing them. That has not changed. We're also asking all businesses to please follow all CDC guidelines to be able to make sure that you are taking well care of your employees and of your clients as well. We need to understand that COVID has not ended. We also need to understand that going green is not the last phase. What comes after green, we do not know yet, but we need to make sure that we're keeping our guard up, that we're doing all that we can to continue to minimize the positive cases that we have, to continue to protect our most vulnerable, such as the elderly and those with underlying medical conditions. So please, let's continue to do our part to stop the spread, because like I said, going green does not mean that we can relax what we're doing and not be aware of what's going on around us. On another note, and I've spoken about this before, but I just wanna reiterate it. If you know of anyone that is having trouble paying their rent due to COVID, There are different rental assistance programs that will be available. There will be more information on the Do Your Part website probably early to mid next week as to what the programs are, where they're accessed, what the guidelines are for each program and so forth. We're currently working on a list of everything that's available to make that available to residents and organizations that may work with people who need rental assistance. So if you do know of anyone who rents and is near to being evicted or has not been able to keep up with the rent due to COVID, please let them know that there are programs that are available for them. Also, Berks County had put out the small business loan program. That loan program has been converted into a grant program. We understand the need that small businesses are going through. We've heard much feedback that small businesses are unsure of the future. They don't know what will, may happen again with COVID. Will they be shut down again? How COVID in fall or spring may affect them? And many of them are not in a position to be able to take on more debt. And understanding that the CARES Act money that is coming through the county, that's coming through the DCED, that is grant money. We did not want to burden the other businesses that went through this initial round with a loan. That's why we decided to move it into a grant. More information will be available on that by tomorrow. It should be on the Neighborhood Housing Services website as well as on the Do Your Part Berks website as well. So get this out to business owners. Please share it. If they're your neighbors, your friends, the, your favorite business, please help them share this. Just to make you aware, there will be three different grant programs for small businesses. One is this initial round that is coming through CDBG block grant monies. It's $1.8 million available for grants. Then there will be the money that is coming through to the county through the CARES Act. How much will be for small business will be available for small businesses? We don't know yet. We're waiting to get through the community needs assessment to determine what the other needs are out there and see how much we can allocate for small businesses. And then the third one is the money that DCED is putting up. It was $225 million. That is specifically going to what are called historically disadvantaged businesses, which are primarily minority-owned businesses. And businesses that are located in rural areas are what are called Main or Elm Street areas. So I know it's a lot of information and people may be wondering, well, what do I apply for? Where do I go? How do I do it? There will be more information as well on that on our Do Your Part Berks website. So we want to make sure that we're getting as much information out. Also, if you have any questions in reference to that, please feel free to reach out to my office. I'll be happy to share any information that I have in reference to that. So again, if you do know of any business owners, please let them know that these grants are available. We understand the importance that businesses play in our local economy. Commissioner Barnhart.
Thank you, Commissioner Rivera, and thank you for covering two significant portions, the Going Green Friday and not letting our guard down, to continue to be as vigilant as possible. We certainly don't want this thing to turn in the other direction. We want to continue to see those numbers decline in our community. And as well as covering the business grant programs, there's a multitude of those out there that you are spearheading for us. So we certainly hope that our businesses take obviously opportunity for these grants to help them to get back to where they need to be. I have a couple of quick items. CARES Act, we did our presentation yesterday to the media and the public. We want to do everything we can to push out the opportunity for those groups that are able to fill out the community needs assessment. It will go online Monday on the County of Berks website. It's a very involved assessment. It will highlight areas like municipalities or public authorities, public health services, not-for-profits that provide social services, educational services, businesses or other service providers. And we put in a lot of places for people to ask questions. We want you to do your level best to fill out the assessment. We need a lot of information for not just a county to make a decision, but also with our partners in this, Whit O'Brien, to help us navigate the almost several hundred CARES Act allocations of funding, not just the monies coming to Berks County, but the ones that are out there. And we get two or three emails a day about new and different CARES Act funding streams. So we want to make sure we are poised to help our community to capture any of that money that should be made available to those organizations. Our email will be communityneeds@countyofberks.com. Again, the survey is going to be out for 2 weeks. We will leave it up after that, but we're really trying to capture what the totality of the needs are in our community over the next 2 weeks from this coming Monday till July 13th. So then as we receive this money, which should be coming very shortly, we can dispense it out to the organizations that need it most. So just to cover what it does qualify for, offsetting the cost of direct county response planning and outreach efforts, purchase of personal protective equipment in response to the pandemic, administration of the grant by the county of no more than 2% of the funds or $200,000, whichever is less. The Board of Commissioners unanimously have agreed to put that money back into the grant, so we would not be taking the $200,000 for the administration of the grant. We are taking it, we're taking the cost of Whit O'Brien out of our general account. Small business grant programs. Grant programs to support entities for costs related to assisting businesses during the COVID disaster. Assisting municipalities for response and planning efforts, including the purchase of PPE, if FEMA does not give them that reimbursement, then we are the second option. Behavioral health and substance use disorder treatment services, nonprofit assistance programs for 501c3s and 501c19 organizations, and broadband deployment with priority given to unserved or underserved areas. So again, this covers some of the county expenses, for example, contact tracing, PPE purchases, our agreement with the Chamber Alliance with Rebuilding Berks Communication Strategy to buy local, connect local, their business training and support, how to restart your business safely and effectively. Going into green, they have been doing that for the past several weeks and have had great success with our small business owners. Government assistance, public health assessment, hospitals and healthcare providers, social service not-for-profits, education K-12, business and other entities. So we do have a line for other entities. We are trying to encourage everyone who has a 501c3 providing social services or a municipality or a business to fill out the assessment. That's the only way we're gonna know how to properly allocate the up to $38 million and to recognize that it's probably woefully inadequate for what this community really needs. When you look at our sisters, Lancaster received $95 million, Chester, I think, was $91 million, Montgomery County, $144 million, and Bucks, $109 million. They received direct allocations from Washington. We received our money through a CARES Act allocation to Harrisburg, and then Harrisburg decided to give out up to $625 million to cover the other 60 counties. There are dozens of other CARES Act funding mechanisms coming out of Harrisburg each and every day. It's hard to keep up. So that's part of the reason we hired Whit O'Brien, was to help our community partners and people in the community who are providing these services and the businesses to look for the right bucket of money to apply for. So we couldn't do it all ourselves and want to thank them again. We're going to be developing a frequently asked questions part of the assessment. When you go online, if we see questions that are asked frequently about the assessment, we're going to post those so people can, we're making this as easy as possible. This is gathering information. So once we have the information, then those potential successful applicants will receive a portal to actually fill out an application. We have a lot of reporting to do. We have a lot of accountability to do here back to DCED, and we want to make sure this money is being spent correctly and effectively in Berks County. Item two, CELG, the Center for Excellence in Local Government, tomorrow at 1 o'clock, we're going to be having a specific Federal Emergency Management Act funding virtual meeting with the municipal leaders to encourage them to go to the FEMA portal and apply for PPE reimbursement from FEMA, because FEMA doesn't have a limit on the amount of money reimbursed. We want to make sure they're applying for FEMA first, and if they're denied or they have expenses that are not covered by FEMA, then they can apply to us. Again, the census keeps moving forward. We have many census tracts in Reading that are woefully under the county numbers and the state and the federal numbers, we need to continue to encourage people to go online and fill out their census. It is so vitally important. I think there's probably 132 federal programs, and there's probably dozens that have been severely impacted just through this COVID-19 pandemic that really are critically important to have the right amount of people counted in Berks County. Item four I have is contact tracing. We have received our weekly update from Coe County Wellness. As of tomorrow, there'll be 42 tracers, 12 part-time paid, and 30 volunteers. Thank you to the volunteers and the part-time paid people. We will have 135 contacts so far, and the response has been extremely good. Only 9 people have refused to cooperate. That's not a bad number. 139 out of 135. Overall response has been good, and people have been genuinely pleased to talk to our tracers and get assistance when needed. So training is on hold for now, but the plan is to train college interns from Kutztown University to cover the fall semester and add help if and when it's needed. They are fully operational with a few glitches and will be ready to ramp up should our going to green spike cause a spike in new infections. Contact tracing combined with increased testing capacity in the county should allow us to contain any new outbreaks quickly. So that's kudos to Carolyn Basic and the Coe County Wellness people for helping us with the contact tracing. So that's all I have. I just wanted to cover what we've been doing the last couple of days for information for the public. And with that, we will open it up to questions. Again, these are comments, public comments. It is really up to the individual commissioners if they choose to respond. It's not a Q&A, although the Microsoft Teams says live event Q&A. Our standard protocol is it's public comment. It's your ability to reach out and speak to the commissioners. If we so inclined to respond, we will do so. Thank you. Jesse, it's up to you now.
Thank you, Commissioner. Okay. Stephanie Williams, Greenwich Township. Good morning, Commissioners. As district consultant for the Reading Library District, serving all residents of Berks County, I express my gratitude for your continued support of the Berks County Public Library System and its 19 member libraries. As you know, the pandemic created several challenges for businesses and nonprofit organizations. Our public libraries adapted to continue providing services while our buildings were closed. Libraries expanded Wi-Fi access in our parking lots, adjusted in-person programming for online delivery, and reallocated funds to meet the surge in demand for digital content. 1,584 new users accessed our digital platform. Overdrive to download ebooks and e-audiobooks. In the past 3 months alone, digital content borrowed in Overdrive increased dramatically by 53% compared to the same time period in 2019. The Reading Library District invested several thousand dollars to provide this year's Summer Quest program on a digital platform. This enables us to continue our work to reduce the summer slide that our children experience while out of school. Libraries will continue to be trusted community partners as we all navigate the new normal. Thank you again for your ongoing support, Stephanie Williams. Next comment, Liz Cates, Burn Township. How often are residents and employees at the Berks Family Detention Center tested for COVID? Comment, William Bellows, why missing? Gentlemen, the movement for Black Lives is sweeping the nation as Americans are finally recognizing the harm done by centuries of systematic racism, including overfunded policing and chronic disinvestment in Black communities. I would like to hear your personal reflections on what you are learning about this subject and how you plan to respond. Next comment, Dr. Neha Madmuder, Lower Heidelberg. Where are we with contact tracing? You hired a firm, but what has the firm set up? If that firm finds that multiple employees from a business test positive, what are the next steps now that we are going in the green? Will that business close? Will the business have to do a deep cleaning? What are the guidelines? Next comment, President Christopher Ellis Redding. The Shutdown Berks Coalition has learned that one of the families detained in Leesport was unjustly deported. The legal folks intervened and they're currently being held in Texas, but they say they'd rather be deported than return to Berks. Three Black Haitian families remain at the center. When will you shut down the center and repurpose it into something of benefit to our community? Next comment, Jane Palmer, Why Missing? Tower Health, one of the largest employers in Berks County and our single most important source for healthcare, has just announced layoffs of at least 1,000 people, the same people who have put their lives on the line caring for us in this pandemic. At the same time, their top management continues to rake in huge salaries. They've also closed the drug and alcohol center at a time when people are most vulnerable and most in need of those services. What will you do to ensure that Tower Health contributes to the financial well-being of our community through payment in lieu of taxes? Comment, Joanne Kozlowski, South Heidelberg Township. If a customer refuses to wear a mask in a business and refuses to leave, or if workers in business places do not have masks worn properly, will there be county level enforcement to ensure customers, workers, and business owners are safe from a potentially dangerous situation? Next comment, Jim Beidler, Burn Township. Pennsylvania has already suffered 6,399 coronavirus deaths. Berks counts 347. But Pennsylvania is now just one of three states, along with Montana and Hawaii, to witness a downward trajectory of COVID-19 cases for more than 42 days. Much of the credit for this achievement must go to Governor Wolf, whose restrictions you and many of your counterparts across the state sought to overturn. Instead of cooperation with the governor's guidelines, you gave us fancy posters and nonsensical statements. And as a result, we still have no shared understanding of how to behave. Now that we're on the brink of going green, will your specific guidelines to the people of Berks County, including wearing masks in all businesses, why or why not? What other guidelines will there be? Next comment, Claudia Strauss, Berkshire Heights. It's been my understanding that individuals are afforded 3 minutes each to during the public comment section of the meeting. Perhaps you are not aware that people's comments are cut off when trying to submit in writing under the new process. I timed my comments before submitting them, reading them aloud slowly to make sure I didn't go over time, and my comments came out to only 2 minutes, and then they didn't fit. The submittal section forced cuts of an entire paragraph and a sentence from another paragraph, so the time permitted was even less than 2 minutes. Please look into this and see whether the submittal space can be adjusted to permit for the usual 3 minutes per person. And in the meantime, please advise all of us how the algorithm is functioning. If it's a word count, we need to know what it is. And it seems that might need to be doubled. Thank you. Next comment, David Del Negro, Why Missing? Commissioners, thank you for your leadership in getting us to green and the small business grant program. COVID has seemed to wax and wane around the country. How do you plan to protect our citizens and businesses? Should we backstep considering a second full-scale shutdown may cause irreparable damage? Thank you. Next comment, Saeed Ahmed, Why Missing? Do you have anything you could say about this question? Are 911 dispatchers going through any training to better tailor responses to calls that don't require police presence? Thank you. The next comment is from Facebook, Nick Dangler from Kutztown. What are the commissioners doing in regards to protecting us residents from unconstitutional contact tracing? Next question, Melvia Ahmed, Why Missing? If there is a spike of COVID-19 in Berks, what educational or other measures are you planning to ensure people know that masks are important, in parentheses, to protect themselves and others, and guidance on social distancing? Next comment, Jess Royer, Spring Township. It's great that Berks County and most of our surrounding area are entering the green phase. Early in the crisis, Governor Wolf and Secretary Levine set the necessary tone and example to get us through coronavirus as quickly as possible, and I thank them and all citizens and businesses that have taken the appropriate steps. It's important now that we remember the strain on all of our lives this has been, but not get complacent. Nationally, coronavirus cases have plateaued rather than showing the steep decline that we need. And locally, we've seen how detrimental Lebanon County's approach has been, as they will be the only PA county not moving to green. Moving forward, Berks County absolutely needs to create a health department. Having a unified county-run department is the best way to track cases and trends here in Berks. Writing for PA Post, Anthea Orozco showed the need for a county health department by highlighting the lack of data on COVID-19 cases among minority communities. A county health department is necessary to protect the health of our county residents. Thank you. And that is all of the comments.
Thank you, Jesse. Now the comment portion is closed. Commissioner Rivera, any comments if you so choose?
Yes, thank you, Commissioner Barnhart. I have a few comments here. I made some notes. First of all, in reference to the libraries, Stephanie, thank you for your comments, and please pass on to the libraries that I and my colleagues as well understand the importance libraries play in our community. They're very important. We thank you for all that you do. We're going to support the libraries in any way that we can. So please keep on doing the work that you're doing, especially now with so many limitations as to what can't be done. People needing internet now for more things. So we really appreciate the work that libraries are doing in our community. So thank you very much. In reference to the Tower Health, and I know there were some questions as well last week in reference to the detox beds and what would be done with the alcohol and drug treatments. Just wanted to update that COCA, Council of Chemical Abuse, was in touch with Pennsylvania Adult and Teen Challenge in reference to seeing if they would be able to take the role of what Tower Health was doing in that aspect, because they're really the only other organization in Berks County that would be able to do that. And Pennsylvania Adult and Teen Challenge did say yes, that they would take on that role, that they would have the detox bed. They do have the capacity to take over what Tower Health was doing and to add capacity as well. So I want to thank Chris and his team there at PA Adult and Teen Challenge for taking this on and helping our community, although they're towards the end of Berks County, they're still an important part of Berks County, and Council on Chemical Abuse look forward to working with the Pennsylvania Adult and Teen Challenge to help our residents in that aspect. There are a few comments in reference to Black Lives Matter. Just want to touch on that and just say that I do recognize that there is systemic racism, something that needs to be addressed, and we need to address it, one, both on a personal level in our lives, the way we interact with people, and also at times we hear people making certain comments or certain jokes that we know aren't correct, and sometimes we stay silent about that. So we need to take action on that part personally, and when something does come up, stand up and let people know that that's not acceptable and that's wrong. And also we need to do it at our place of work, what we can. As Commissioner Leinbach had mentioned either last week or a few weeks ago, the county is looking at different things that can be done in reference to the law enforcement rated areas. The county does not have control over the local police departments, the sheriff's departments, the DA's office, but we do know that the DA and the sheriff's office here are well aware, and they're doing, and for many years they have been working on different issues related to that. The county has direct control over the jail. So we're looking at putting different things in place that will help. We did learn what those departments did now. So we're looking to see what can be done differently, and also reaching out to the local police departments and asking them to take action in this matter as well, to make sure that everyone is treated equitably when it has anything to do in reference to law enforcement. And it goes much more than the law enforcement, it goes into business. I've seen it happen in the real estate industry. My wife and I are realtors, and we've seen things happen there, which doesn't make us real happy either. So we do need to understand that this is something that is real. I tell people, I don't know what it is. I'm Hispanic, but if you look at me, you can see I'm white. I don't have much of an accent when I talk. So many people, if they don't hear me talking Spanish, they don't know that I am. But I do have many friends, both black and brown, that have gone through this situation personally, and they told me about it. So we do need to understand that this does exist. And if we don't go through it, sometimes we feel that it maybe it not be real, or that it doesn't exist, but it does. If anyone does have any thoughts as to anything else that the county could do or I personally can do, I'd be happy to have a conversation with you. So please feel free to reach out to my office. There are various comments in reference to the wearing of masks, the use of PPP, what happens now that we go to green, letting our guard down and so forth. And this is something I had commented on before, but I do want to reiterate again that the county is standing firm on saying we need to follow the government guidelines. There was a comment in there about the governor guidelines and the posters that we make and the statements that we make. I just want to clarify that the posters we make and the comments and statements that we make are based on the governor's guidelines. So there's really no difference between the governor's guidelines and what we put out there. So one thing does not contradict the other, and it never has. We've always said we need to do our part. We need to continue to wear a mask. We need to continue with social distancing. Businesses need to continue doing the right thing to protect their employees and their clients as well. The Greater Reading Chamber Alliance, they're working with businesses on making sure that the businesses are opening up in a safe way, in a healthy way. And we're also working with them to make sure that these businesses are following the proper health and safety guidelines. They put out their three-day course, an hour and a half each day, to make sure that business is open properly. They're asking businesses to put up a poster as well, indicating the guidelines and saying that they're following those guidelines. There's really nothing that the county can do if a business is not following the guidelines. The county has no control over that. And the state, when the governor set that up, first of all, the county does not have any policing authority, and the county, second, was not given any authority to go into business and mandate that they do anything. So what we can do and what we are doing is asking people, encouraging businesses to do their part, to help them understand why they should do their part. I understand that there's many different points of view in reference to this. But here at the county, at least I feel that we need to continue what we have been doing so far, and we can't let our guard down now that they're in green. So if you do have any issues with a business that is blatantly disregarding the guidelines, please reach out to John Adams, the district attorney's office, and they will have someone look into that. There was a comment on IT on reference to looking at the algorithm and the amount of space that someone has to write in. We will have our IS department look into that. Don't know if it may be, you know, if it's something that we can change on our end, or if it's just a limitation of the Microsoft Teams, and if so, what can be done about it. But thank you for making us aware of that. We will have someone look into that. And then one other comment is in reference, there was the comment reference to contact tracing. Just to be clear, and I believe Commissioner Barnhart has mentioned this, I don't know if he mentioned it today, but he has mentioned it many times before. The contact tracing is not mandatory. He said we had 9 people that did not want to participate. That is your right. We feel that it's important, that contact tracing is important to be able to mitigate and lower the amount of positive cases. If you feel differently, we respect that. You do not have to participate. with Cole County Wellness is not supposed to be maintaining any type of records for this. But we understand if you don't feel comfortable with it, by all means say, you know what, I don't want to participate, I'm not interested, and that is your right to do so, and we respect that, and you do not have to participate. So just wanted to make that clear that we do understand both points of view, and those who don't want to participate, again, you know, it's that's your choice, and feel free to do so. And Commissioner, that's all I have.
Thank you, Commissioner Rivera. And I too would like to commend the library and all of their members for the great job they do in our community. Several weeks ago, we had asked our director, Amy Resch, to compile the list of expenses of our libraries, which are all independently operated, what they've expended so far for PPE, and the county is going to cover that cost for our libraries, all 23 of them. So that's how much we care about our libraries. I think when it comes to enforcement and masks and what the county is going to do, again, we have limited, if no enforcement other than through the DA, enforcing regulations and rules in the county. We're a commonwealth, not a state. A lot of people confuse the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania and other states where counties have an awful lot of say-so in police, fire, emergency services, codes, and enforcement of ordinances. Different animal here in Pennsylvania. But I would say the county is setting an example. We have been following CDC guidelines. We are strongly encouraging anyone who comes into the county facilities for any purpose to come in by appointment. We are temperature checking, and we are requiring masks, and we're requiring 6 feet distance. If you come into our buildings and you're in the elevator, only 4 people are permitted in an elevator in each corner. We are doing our best to set a tone out there in the community. Likewise, through the Chamber Alliance, have been training small business owners how to restart their business safely and effectively. So I think we're doing a pretty decent job. Obviously, we can always do better. I think the messaging was clear and impactful. We started that early on in the COVID-19 pandemic, and I think it's been highly effective. You know, most people are going to conform and comply because they don't want to get sick. They don't want to get their loved ones sick and people that they know. But there are some people out there who just feel as though it's not, that they're not obligated. They don't have to worry about things, or they just think it's a hoax. And we can only impact so many people in our community. So we, I think, are doing the best we can, and we'll continue to do that certainly into the future. As we are, again, dispersing the CARES Act money. Again, a large part of that is going to be for continuing PPE and protective equipment for our community to continue to keep us safe until there is a vaccine for this virus. So I have nothing else. If there are any other comments, if not, Commissioner Rivera, I'll entertain a motion to adjourn.
Motion to adjourn.
Second. Have a good day.